can digitalization help make firms more resilient to economic shocks? Lockdowns and social distancing measures imposed in response to the pandemic led to radical rethinking of business models, with firms moving operations online and having to implement smart working solutions. My name is Sarah Sucker, and I'm here to explain how digitalization helped mitigating economic losses arising from the pandemic for firms in the Middle East and Central Asia. If you start by looking at countries in the region, we will see that they're catching up in some digitally related areas, such as per capita internet usage. However, countries in the region are still behind in other aspects of digitalization. If you look at fixed broadband subscriptions in the MENA region, for example, we will see that the region is still lagging behind. Now we go in a little deeper and try to assess the role of digitalization on business performance during the pandemic. For this, we use the European Bank of Reconstruction Development, World Bank, Business Environment and Enterprise Performance Survey that collects information on unlisted companies since 2002. The survey takes the pulse of businesses across several important dimensions, such as sales, insolvency, and most importantly, some measures of digitalization. Specifically, the survey asks firms whether they have their own website, invested in and adopted digital technologies, and if they use email to connect to clients and suppliers. The key empirical issue we face is to disentangle whether the impact on company sales during the pandemic was a result of supply or demand constraints. On the supply side, firms lost their capacity to produce due to COVID-19 restrictions or faced constraints in sourcing inputs from suppliers. On the demand side, consumer spending fell during the pandemic due to the loss of income. In order to tackle this identification issue, we introduced a difference in differences methodology where we examined the sales of digitally enabled firms against digitally constrained ones. Using over 18,000 observations of firm-level data from 13 economies in the Middle East and Central Asia, we found that, first, firms in the region are heterogeneous in adopting digital technologies. The share of firms with a website ranged between 67% to around 30% depending on the country. Second, our analysis shows that there is systematic evidence that digitalization can play a mitigating role in helping companies be more resilient in times of shocks. Firms that invested in digital technologies before the crisis experienced a 4 percentage point smaller decline in sales during the pandemic than those that did not. Therefore, firm resilience during the pandemic can be partly attributed to investment in digital technologies. Given the role of digitalization during the pandemic, closing the digital divide across firms emerges as one of the main policy priorities in the post-pandemic world to stimulate economic growth, achieve structural transformation, and enhance the resilience of the private sector. This would include policies such as increasing broadband network, which can help improve digital connectivity, reducing barriers to market entry so that other innovative, digitally enabled firms could enter the market and facilitate the diffusion of digital technologies, improve financing for firms to help with the costs of adopting digitalization, and finally, ensuring the provision of relevant skills for the digital age, which will require substantial investments in education and digital training. The pandemic has highlighted the importance of digital technologies in helping firms become more resilient and in weathering economic shocks. The good news is that 35% of all firms in the Middle East and Central Asia have increased their digitalization efforts as a result of the pandemic. If they continue investing in digital technologies, firms are certain to become more resilient to future shocks.